It's the brew review. Let's go. It's the brew review. Let's go. It's the brew review. Everybody get your hands up for the brew review. Come on everybody, let's dip it on back. Body, head, and cap, show me what you got on that tap. Cause it's K-Dog and Mr. GMC. Everybody here knows that it's BYOB. Tell me how it tastes, tell me how it smells. Is it that old bud or that Ying-a-ling hell? But it's time to get it started, so we start it off right. It's the brew review, so we gonna party all night. Let's go. It's the brew review. Let's go. It's the brew review. Let's go. It's the brew review. Everybody get your hands up for the brew review.
Arr, good evening, everybody.
Arr.
And we are back for yet another fun edition of the brew review. And what we got for you today is another two products from Heavy Seas.
Yes, Heavy Seas, the makers of Peg Leg and Cutlass.
Yes, and Peg Leg, we didn't like at first, but then it totally redeemed itself.
Totally.
So we did a redo on it also this season, about maybe a month ago.
Yes, but tonight we have two new ones. We have the Gold, and we have Loose Cannon.
Ooh. Only fitting.
Loose Cannon is a Hop 3 IPA.
Now, is this shit brewed underground here, the Gold?
Probably it is,
it's the Gold nail, so if you dump it on you get a golden shower.
Yeah, you open the chest and you find the Gold. And Gold is pretty much like their simple.
Would you say
ale.
She likes the golden shower on the chest?
She likes the golden shower on the treasure chest. I have no idea. I'm not related to this guy at all.
Bullshit.
Doesn't really say. Oh, wait, yeah, it does. Accented by golden waves of pale wheat and mellow caramel malts, this uniquely American brew starts with a citrusy hop nose but goes down crisp and clean. 4.5.
So it's modest. It's your average.
And then this one is our Loose Cannon Hop 3 Ale is opulently.
Never heard that word before.
Neither did I. That's a big word. Hopped 3 times in the brewing process. Herbal and aromatic, an amazingly graceful American IPA. This bitch is 7.25.
Ooh, so this is a strong'un.
Oh yeah, but I think Peg Leg was way stronger than both of them. I think that was like 8.
So, to get the real history on this, you want to go all the way back to episode 3, was it?
Episode 3 for the original Peg Leg. Cutlass was, I think,
53?
Somewhere season 2-ish.
I think it was episode... I think it was season 2.
It's the beginning of season 2 somewhere. And then season 3, we redid Peg Leg just about a few weeks ago.
Yeah, so, as usual, as tradition, we're going to do the cap test, the body and head test, the drink test, the draft test, all that good stuff. So, let's get started. And I forgot to take a loose, I forgot to take a good look at the bottles, like I normally do.
Oh, and you probably are wondering by now.
And I do like the packaging, by the way, of this one.
Yeah, you're probably wondering right now, where the hell is Squishy Frog at? He's on vacation.
Are you sure you didn't fire him? Ooh,
no,
Best Buy March 2015.
I didn't fire him.
Yes, we are. It is February as we record this.
Yeah.
And we look at the Gold. And, okay, now let's begin.
Arr.
Sorry about that.
Yeah, like I'm going to give that fat bitch a fucking vacation.
Go ahead. I guess we'll do the weaker one first.
Yeah, we'll go ahead and do Gold.
Yeah, and like I said, Clipper City Brewing Company, LP, Baltimore, Maryland.
Yep.
So, kind of a local.
Baltimore.
And yeah, we pretty much determined that you can't twist them.
Bastards are really locked on there.
We already demonstrated on the redo of Peg Leg how we had to open it back in the day. Because we didn't even have enough money to even get a fucking opener.
Yeah, we're not doing that.
So,
man.
We'll do the smell test on the Gold. Slight bit of fruit or grape, but it's not overbearing.
Slight bit. It's an ale.
It's actually a good smell.
Yeah, it's definitely an ale-ish.
So it has
smell.
Your fruity, like, grass, hoppy smell to it.
Just a hint, not a lot.
Yeah, it's not overbearing like we've had in the past.
You smell it, but it's... I've tried this before, it's not as strong.
So...
He's gonna have a golden shower in his mouth.
For the 100 and I forgot how many fucking times.
Who knows?
Heavy Seas! Gold Ale! Let's try it! Alright.
And
we will do the flavor burst.
Flavor.
There is head in the bottle, as you can see.
That frothy amount right there. Frothy!
It is transparent. I can see my hand through it. So it's. We already know it's gonna be a light one. This is pretty I know. Shut the fuck up and drink.
Yeah, just shut up and drink it.
It's not bad. I like it. It actually, you can't even taste the fruit of grape and the taste of
it. No.
It's weird. It tastes different than it smells.
Like you said, the smell is very deceiving.
But I do like it. It kind of reminds me of Shock Top a little bit. If I had to compare to anything.
I would consider just like a light beer.
Yeah, but a very good light beer.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't taste like a budgety big box beer.
No,
either.
No. This is like kind of like your Coors Regular or your Buds.
It's one of those you can actually sit down and enjoy, I think.
Exactly, yeah.
So let's see if it is gold.
So gold in the Excalibur glass.
Do you know if Romeo's working the night?
Romeo. And he brought us all steak at Tender. Oh, that lovely little chap.
For $25.
Love the spanky hairy bottom. Yeah, very transparent.
Very carbonated looking. It's more of a cream soda.
Yeah, cloudy-ish almost.
More carbonated than cloudy, I'd say.
Mm-hmm.
But he swirls.
I smell. I savor.
Your finger's not up for once. Holy shit.
A little bit.
You gotta put Viagra in that bitch.
Yeah. But.
I like the afterburp.
Taste-wise, no real difference. At least in my opinion. But it goes down smooth. I mean, it doesn't lie. The bottle says it goes down crisp and clean and smooth.
You're right. It's about the same either way you do it.
Yeah, I don't see much of a difference in the glass and the bottle.
But yeah, I mean, I really like it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely.
I can tell you already, I recommend it.
Definitely.
So, I'm going to open this.
And now we go to Loose Cannon. Now,
and the cap is anything but loose.
This bastard will knock your ass off with 7.25.
Yeah. Alright, so it hissed. We got the cap off, and I'm going to smell it.
And he's going to sniff it. He's going to shove it right his nose in that cannon. And ooh.
Good smell, but fucking strong smell.
Yeah. You smell the alcohol in this one. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's... This one will probably knock you on your ass if you drink enough of it. Yeah. I'm going to tell you right now.
I'll go ahead and brave it. The first
okay.
one. So, cheers.
And beers. I gotta say credit to Eric Pressler Music yet again for the intro that we've been playing all season.
Yeah, my brother and my nephew love that song. They actually asked if that was us singing it. I'm like, no, we got Pressler doing it. So, kudos, man. You got two fans.
Holy shit. So, Eric Pressler Music, go like them on Facebook. And don't forget to like us on Facebook as well while you're at it.
Mm.
I just posted a road rage incident off my camera system on Stupid Random Bit of the Day, so check out that list too.
Okay, so this is it's an IPA, all right, an American IPA.
Yeah, normally IPA, we don't generally like the IPAs, but they're growing.
Well, yeah, usually your IPAs are really dry, really hoppy, great.
Like the dry mouth like taste to them.
Grass taste to it. This has it. But it's nowhere near as strong as your other ones, nectar, your Hellraisers.
Well, I can tell you based on smell that I didn't smell any grass in this. I smelled more alcohol, really.
Right, but honestly, it goes down just as smooth.
Yeah, okay.
You might actually be surprised.
There is a slight bit of grass if you really smell the hell out of it.
Yeah, you might actually be surprised with the taste.
So, Heavy Seas, Loose Cannon, Hop IPA. Let's try it, if I read that right.
Yeah, whatever.
Okay, and flavor burst?
Flavor burst. And verdict?
It almost has like a stout, dark taste to it.
Yeah, I'm actually interested to see what it looks like in the glass.
You would think an IPA, it actually leaves that aftertaste. Oh, I forgot about that opener too.
It's a good thing I saw that.
Yeah, it would have got poured in the cup there.
Well, as you know, I have 20/20 vision. My eyesight is damn near perfect. It is. So we're going to turn it, and wow!
Yeah, and my ankle's perfect.
It's actually...
Look at it, it's light!
Lighter than what I thought.
Right there's about a half inch ahead, going down to a centimeter.
But again, it looks like an IPA, which is what it's supposed to be. It's what it is.
See, I expected it to be dark the way it tasted, so the taste of it kind of threw me off a little bit.
Yeah.
But not a bad taste, nevertheless.
Nice frothy head on that. Here, you go ahead and do the glass on the first one. Get a big whiff of that. You get a nice aroma.
I'm thinking the head's keeping the smoke from coming out because I really can't smell it now.
Really? Because I got a pretty good aroma.
There's cinnamon floating around in there. Look. There is cinnamon.
Cinnamon?
Not cinnamon. Cinnamon.
Cinnamon.
There is cinnamon inside that beer.
There is cinnamon.
So not cinnamon. Let's draft it.
Cinnamon. Not cinnamon. It'll make a cinnamon. Well, it may make a cinnamon beer.
Okay, this is one you got to draft.
And Nala's drinking beer, too. No, she's not really drinking.
Yeah, dog's got to be like the age of 3 to drink legally.
No, definitely. It's all. I think all heavy seas is better draft.
Now, the one thing that gets me about this one, I liked it. However, there is a but.
But. Big, hairy, smelly butt.
That farts. Okay, we're getting too deep in this. Okay. But the one thing that gets me on this would be the aftertaste.
Aftertaste is a little bad.
It now,
definitely IPA aftertaste.
It doesn't stick around as long as you would think. However, it's like if I had to like be a critic on this, and yeah, aftertaste kind of gets it, but I still like it. So
not as bad as like your IP, like you say, Hellraiser, Nugget Nectar, the ones that we have not really liked that much. Maybe it's because it's been brewed 3 times.
Yeah.
Three, I don't know. So, rating wise, what would you do?
Huh. Well, Loose Cannon, yeah, it's got an awesome package, so I'll give it points for that.
Mm-hmm.
Same with the gold, points for that.
Mm-hmm.
So, well, if it wasn't for the aftertaste, I would say like a 4, but the aftertaste to me bumped it down to a 3.5. I would still get a 6-pack of it.
Right.
Now, the gold, definitely case-worthy. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say a 5 out of 5. I loved it.
Really?
Yeah, 5 out of 5 on the gold. Standing ovation.
Very good, yeah.
So 3.5 and 5.
I agree with you on the gold. I'll give 5 for that. Love that shit. Loose Cannon. Again, the aftertaste was bad, but I'm going to compare it to all the other IPAs that we've had. Not as bad.
Yeah.
I'm going to give it a 4.
So 4 on Loose Cannon, 5 on the gold.
4 or 5, yeah. So you got 5, 3.5. Recommendable.
It's both weird. This one here, the Loose Cannon, I kind of started off as a 3.5. Then I thought, oh, cool packaging. Let's give it a 4. Then the aftertaste bumped it back down to 3.5.
Right.
So
fucking aftertaste.
But yeah, all in all, good beer. Definitely recommend the gold.
So, Heavy Seas, you did all right.
Yeah, you've been really redeeming yourself since that third episode with the peg leg that tasted like cough syrup.
We didn't like peg leg at all, but now you've kind of gotten back on the board. So, you're back on the board.
Yeah, and Cutlass. Recommend that one,
and
too.
And Cutlass, yes.
Not the car.
Not the car.
But, all right, so I hope you enjoyed this edition of the Brew Review featuring Loose Cannon and Golden Shower.
Golden Shower.
And, yeah, we got more where that came from, and we'll see you next week.